morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assem Live. This is Assem Sports. Terrific, thundering, Super Tuesday. Premier League games return. The end is almost near. The season is almost over. And if I could pick one word to describe this season of the Premier League, one would say it was a chaotic season. Drama, frantic, everywhere. The most manager firings in history when it comes to the Premier League this season, and more managers are still being fired and new ones are in the talks of being hired. Thank you for tuning into Assem Sports. We're talking Premier League games that went over the weekend, but the Premier League returns on this terrific thundering Tuesday where Wolves are playing Crystal Palace. Before we get to that, Stellini, the Tottenham manager, interim manager who took over from Antonio Conte, has been fired after that embarrassing, disgraceful defeat to Newcastle over the weekend. Stellini has been fired at Tottenham Hotspur. Daniel Levy, the CEO, put out a statement. There's also been talks about Mauricio Pochettino. Mauricio Pochettino's rumored to be the next manager at Chelsea. And once again, I want to ask, why who are making these decisions at my club, and why is Mauricio Pochettino top on the list when it comes to the future of this Chelsea team and the squad? Before Chelsea even gets a manager, the first thing they should do, this decision should never be done in a rush. There shouldn't be any type of impulse going on there, on like just impulsive buying, impulsive hiring. Just take your time, Todd Bolio. Relax, the season is almost over. We still haven't getting a better explanation as to the reason why Frank Lampard was hired back again at Chelsea, only because of the fact that it will please the fans. And in as much as Frank Lampard is off to a woeful start, nobody expected Frank Lampard to be the savior. Excuse me. All respect to Frank Lampard as a player, as a manager, he's had a little bit of difficulty in his beginning career. It's fine. It's okay. He will grow up to be a better manager in the future. But right now, Frank Lampard in charge is not helping. And by the end of the season, Chelsea should be able to offload certain players. That should be the first thing they should do. Cut off the chaff from the team. This is just common sense. I'm not even speaking from a football, technical, tactical, genius perspective. I'm just talking from common sense. Cut off the chaff. All the players who are just extras hanging on. There's no prospective future in their playing career at Chelsea. Let them go before then you can find a way. I mean, I don't know about Mauricio Pochettino, but if by then Pochettino is not going anywhere, there's no rush to sign Pochettino. If any team wanted him, he would have been already in a job. PSG fired him because he was unable to replicate the success that he was able to do at Tottenham Hotspur. At Spurs, he was great, don't get me wrong. But what Chelsea needs right now is beyond a new coach. First, they have to cut off the chaff. Thank you for tuning into Assem Sports. Mauricio Pochettino, former manager of PSG, has been rumored to be the next manager to take over Chelsea. I mean, Frank Lampard is currently the interim manager. Let me know what you think about it. But Premier League games are back on this Tuesday, terrific Tuesday. Cloudy grey Tuesday, and the battle for the relegation in the Premier League is almost as exciting as the battle for the top four. The top four race is still on. Manchester City is running behind the Gunners, and the third and fourth place. I would rather see Manchester United and Newcastle play Champions League next season. Let me know who you think should fill in that fourth and third place. Aston Villa is playing Fulham today, another mid-level battle. Aston Villa and Fulham. Leeds United, a battle for the bottom, like I was talking about. Leeds United is playing Leicester City, a game that is very, very important for Leeds United. They look like they might be drowning based on their performance and their uptick. But Leicester City hasn't been also extremely impressive this season, so that must be a very exciting game to watch. And tomorrow, Nottingham Forest is playing Brighton. Chelsea is in a game against Brentford. West Ham is playing Liverpool, and the almighty clash where Arsenal is playing against Manchester City. The decider of the season, whoever wins that game stands such, I mean, it's still not over even if they win or lose, but whoever wins that game puts themselves in a better position for the long, short run. Thank you for tuning into Awesome Sports. We're talking terrific Tuesday Premier League games coming on today. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0, a collection of songs by the Musical King. New ASEM Music Collection, the Forecast 1.0, available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. This has been Awesome Sports. We'll be done.